Doug, honey, where are you? The debate's about to start.
Right here, Madam Laura. Is I, Doug.
Oh. Looks like I gotta notify the Secret Service because we are under a snack attack.
Oh. Dougie, I am feeling good tonight. We have got momentum. Liz Cheney's about to endorse me, and Bruce Springsteen. Let me say that again. And Bruce Springsteen. Because maybe I was born to run.
Hey, and the polls are looking great, and I may have accidentally Googled myself, too. Turns out some people are calling me a grilf, which means golden retriever I'd like to French.
Huh. I'm pretty sure that's wrong.
Yeah, it's probably wrong.
Yeah.
Anyway, when Joe Biden said see you later, did he mean he was coming over tonight?
No, he went back to the White House.
Oh, looks like it's just Mamala and Pooh Bear.
Dougie.
All right, let's watch.
Okay.
Hello and welcome to the CBS Vice Presidential Debate. I'm Nora O'Donnell.
I'm Margaret Brennan.
Now let's say hello and then goodbye for the next 4 years to our vice presidential candidates, J.D. Vance and Tim Walz.
It's a good handshake. I like this guy.
Gentlemen, welcome to the debate. Mr. Vance, please give your opening statement.
Thank you for having me. I want to begin with something that will appeal to women voters. I understand that both the moderators tonight are mothers, and I like that.
Okay. And Governor Walz, it looks like you're already scribbling a bunch of notes. Are you preparing your answers?
Nah, I got to grade these papers. Got to stack midterms.
Okay. We begin tonight with the topic of Israel. Senator Vance, how would you solve the ongoing crisis in the Middle East?
You know, that is such an important question, Margaret, one that deserves an answer, because it's important. And it's a question that you asked of me tonight.
You're not going to answer, are you?
No, I'm not.
And Governor Walz, same question to you.
I don't know the answer, so I'm going to just say the word fundamental a bunch. Because debating is 30% fun and 70% demental. How am I doing?
Okay. He's out there. He's doing his thing, whatever that may be.
Come on, just relax. You know, you haven't had a night off in 3 months. Do you want to watch something less stressful like the Menendez Brothers show?
I don't know, Dougie. I kind of wish I had picked Josh right now.
Oh, Josh Shapiro?
No, Josh. Cabernet.
Look, Tim'll be fine. It's not like he's gonna say something crazy.
I've become friends with school shooters.
Okay, little flub there.
Uh-huh. You know what, Doug? You were right. Let's watch something more fun. Ooh, like a rerun of my debate. Remember when I said his crowds were tiny and I broke his brain?
Of course I do. Look, this isn't easy for me either. As a goofy white guy, this really sets my fellas back. I'm in a group chat with Josh Gad and Jason Kelsey, and the mood is dark.
We now turn to the gotcha portion of the debate. Senator Vance, you called Donald Trump America's Hitler. Do you regret that?
Well, the context matters. I meant that as a compliment.
Wow, this guy's good. He's got an answer for everything.
Thank you. That's quite kind.
Hey, you're welcome.
Okay. I'm not sure why you two are connecting, but let's move on. Governor Walz, you claimed you were in Hong Kong during the 1989 Tiananmen Square massacre when you were home in Minnesota. Can you explain that?
So I think what happened is I went to Epcot. You can go around the whole world, and I had a couple in the Germany section, and I thought I went to China. Anyway, I'm a knucklehead. But I'm sure this guy has some things he'd want to, you know, back out of as well.
He's right about that. That's an area where we have a lot of common ground.
Why
Mamala, it's Joe Biden.
I can't talk right now. Tell him I'm not here.
No, no, like he's in the room.
Oh. Oh.
You're not here. I'll come back later.
No, Joe. Come in. Come in. Have a seat. Nice and dry.
You've been watching this guy? Come on, Walsh. What's wrong with that guy? He's crazy. Get your facts straight, Jack. You gotta hit him with a no joke. Here's the deal. Let me be clear. Anyway, guess what? And by the way, you should be talking about all the great things we've done. Gas prices down. Border crossings down. Emmys for the Bear down. Everybody get down. Tonight. Anyway.
And now we turn to reproductive rights. Governor Walz, what would you do on this issue?
In Minnesota, we restored a woman's right to choose because we trust women. And in Minnesota, we also happen to have the lowest teen pregnancy rates, probably because everyone's wearing a lot of layers and eating a lot of lake fish. Just not a horny place.
And Senator Vance, your favorability rating on this issue is negative 100. What is your current stance?
Yeah, Republicans need to do much better on this issue of building trust back with voters. That's why I'm keeping all my real opinions up here.
Well, we'd like to end tonight on the topic of democracy. Senator Vance, your running mate refused to accept the results of the last election. Would you have certified the results?
You know, Nora, it's rich to say that Donald Trump is a threat to democracy when he peacefully gave over power. We said no fact-checking. And willingly, don't check that, got on his plane without incident, right after saving Obamacare. Don't check that.
Well, if we're allowed to stand up here and lie, then I would like to say I actually was in Tiananmen Square. And you know what? There's 10 seconds on the clock here, and I got to get some points on the board here, so I'm just going to chuck a Hail Mary. Senator, will you admit that Donald Trump lost the election?
You know, Tim, I'm focused on the future.
Boom! It's good.
Honey, we did it. We got the sound bites. What are the pollsters saying?
Well, this is a huge victory. It made no difference.
That's right. Hey, kiddo. Let me give you a little bit of a pep talk. Mm. Here's the deal. Mm. I'm being serious right now. Come on, look at me. I'm serious right now. It's about the president. Pardon me. The vice president doesn't matter.
Well,
I mean, who the hell knows? Who the hell was Obama's VP? Nobody knows.
That was you. That was you.
You're gonna make a great president. And when you're done, it'll be my turn. Biden, 2028. And one more thing.
Live from New York, it's Saturday.